Now, hello. So we're gonna start the Dyson Zone from the very beginning, just as Admiral 4 implied. So to do that, we went to the Iconian Gateway. Shit. There's something I'm missing here. There is a mission you get from Romulus that I think should be before this. Isn't that mission supposed to be before the start of the Dyson stuff? Episodes, Solenoid Dyson Sphere. Yes. Okay, that's exactly the mission we're on right now. Okay, I thought that we were going to just go into it. Okay, so there is an actual mission we're doing right now. It's not just just the introduction to the Dyson Zone. So let's do Sphere of Influence. The gateway discovered beneath the surface of New Romulus is prepared and ready for activation. Because the Romulan Republic is dedicated to sharing the gateway and all we learn from it with our allies, we are inviting representatives of the Romulan Republic, the Federation, and the Klingon Defense Force to join us on New Romulus for the first trip through the gateway. I would be honored if you would join us, Admiral. Okay, so we actually need to go to... Oh, nice, 10k skill points. Ancient Omnidirectional Beam Array. Mmm, delicious. I'm actually going to have to get both of these, I think. Because they're pretty good. 50% recharge time on slipstream drive. Turn rate and stuff. Auxiliary power. Auxiliary power... we'll see. Accept. Okay, and Sphere of Influence is actually on New Romulus. I was also almost starting this this stuff without going into the introductory mission, which would have been bad. Admiral asks, why the fuck are you catching on other ships when you're trying to auto-navigate to New Romulus? Actually, that's not what he asked, but I'm looking at the screen and it's just so fucking stupid. Do I have permission to back you up, cause the Voth ships are very, very tough? Thank you very much for the offer. I will let you know. But I'll try to get in there and then do it on my own when we get to it. I think the cruiser can handle it. I have the stuff from the Kobali set and the console from the Tier 6 cruiser. So I think I'm doing pretty well for survivability stuff. Okay. And I think after we finish this mission, we're gonna do the bridge officer stuff that I was promising. Alrighty. This should be a good mission. This isn't going to be as boring as I thought it was going to be. There are two really nice missions during the Dyson arc. First one is the introduction right here, and there is going to be one later on involving Tuvok. This one is actually featuring Worf. That is one bad, bad ass, I guess, setup. No need to pardon your language, Admiral. I don't know why it got censored. This is supposed to be on mature mode for the channel. So, I don't know if that was on your part, or if something is filtering that I have not properly disengaged. We do cuss a lot on this channel. Like, fucking shit, fuck, all over the place. There's no filter. by the way, strong language warning, if you have kids watching, now is the time to send them to bed. Or actually, don't have kids watching my channel because I cuss whenever I feel like it. it's not cuss-based, but I cuss whenever I feel like it. Now we are at New Romulus. Pardon the delay. Records indicate that the colony ship that left Vulcan after the sundering spent several months on this planet. Mostly abandoned since then, the M-class world is now the home of New Romulus, a colony made up of Romulans and Riemans seeking to create a new society and a new homeworld. Radiation levels and seismic instability on the planet indicate that there was a worldwide cataclysmic event in this world's distant past. It will take more study to determine exactly what happened. You get a lot more interaction with New Romulus, of course, if you are a Romulan, if you are in the RRF. Start sphere of influence. Interesting. Hidden doing some very creative cussing in chat. I don't think I've ever seen those words before. Good job, Hidden.
Welcome to New Romulus.
Liaison Frenic. Welcome to New Romulus, Admiral. I'm Frenic, and I serve as a liaison officer for the Tan. As you can see, we've established the environment in this area as part of our investigations of the gateway. Protective gear is no longer necessary. Admiral Kererek is waiting for you in the gateway chamber. Alrighty. Now this mission is actually pretty nice looking, I have to say. Like, look at that stuff underneath. You can't even tell that this game is that old if you look at it. Very nice effects. Very nice atmosphere. Ceilings are incredibly high still, and that's not just because my character is really short. We have people from the RRF here. Now I will say something, other than the fact that this lady has a nice ass, which by the way I'm going to take a screenshot of. Anyway, a lot of people criticize the RRF uniforms. That is supposed to be a tactical one, probably. Science and engineering, I guess. They look kind of bad. I don't personally dislike the RRF uniforms, but my RRF officer has the exact same uniform as an engineering officer, so I don't do the tinting, and the colors are a bit more sharp. They're a little bit sharper, because the colors on the basic engineering uniform are a little bit faded and bland, I would say. Maybe I'll show it to you sometimes. Yeah. Which is a shame, because they did a really nice job with standardizing the Starfleet uniforms, but the RRF uniforms are kind of bleh. And the KDF, I think, are now standardized as the Bortascu uniforms. But I don't have access to those, so sadly, sad face. Consoles. Engineering porn. Oh, look at them cables. Oh, yes, the console. Oh, yes. Yeah. This is like a birthday present for an engineering officer. Yes. Please come to this conference where we are going to use the Iconian Gateway for the first time. By the way, there is also officers specializing in engineering from all over the known galaxy. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Finally, something that caters to my character's specialty. Sadly, there's not going to be anything related to engineering happening in this mission. Well, yeah. Talk to Admiral Kererek.
Welcome.
That's okay, just one word. Welcome, Admiral. The Romulan Republic is here, along with representatives from our allies in the Federation and the Klingon Empire, to witness the dawn of a new age. Harnessing the power of this gateway will change everything for our people. Yes, we must be cautious. The Dewans tried to do the same, and it destroyed them. Who are the Dewans? I don't know. But we have been studying this gateway since its discovery, and believe that we understand where they went wrong. We now have the technology and knowledge we need to successfully adapt Iconian technology for our own use. Ooh, we're gonna get fucked up. We have a few final adjustments to make, and then we'll be ready to... Worf interrupts.
You think you have corrected the issue? Consider what happened to the Dewans, and what the result would be if the Romulans lose a second homeworld.
And yes, that is actually Michael Dorn. They actually got him to do the voice.
I have encountered Iconian gateways twice before. In both those instances, The finest commanders I ever served found the technology to be too dangerous to preserve. It is difficult to believe that you have managed to do what they could not.
Are there problems, Worf?
No problem.
No problems, Admiral. Well, I wasn't talking to you, Kararek. Fuck off. Ambassador Worf was invited here because of his experience with Iconian gateways. He has been voicing his concerns with our decision to activate the gateway. My science teams are convinced that they have solved the problems of the past, but I fear that, like the ambassador, some of my engineers have their doubts. The Tan and the Senate believe this to be an important step for the New Republic, but it is a step that we must take with our allies. We respect their opinions and want them to join us in this venture, just as the Bajorans and the Federation worked in tandem when the wormhole to Gamma Quadrant was discovered. In the interests of easing some concerns, Ambassador, I invite you to take a final check of the data to make, whatever. Perhaps Admiral Blastrench could be willing to assist you. I'm ready to assist you, Ambassador.
Acceptable. Admiral Kararek. I want to start by reviewing your science team's work.
I actually want to talk to Captain Corin as well. She is the captain of the flagship of the KDF. And you get to see a lot more of her after this particular point in time. Relatively. Not that much, but you know, it's relatively a lot compared to any other character. Okay, I can just go back there and talk to her, I guess. Oh, and there was someone else. Ooh, Liaison Frenic. Let's see what they have to say about this setup here.
Daughter of Grilka, captain of the mighty IKS Fortescue, and survivor of 100 battles.
I would much rather be on the front than here, but the Romulans are our allies now, and they have asked for our assistance. The High Council has dispatched the flagship of the fleet to show the strength of our friendship. Klingon friendship. We will kick your ass, but then we'll be friends. Or even better, you can kick our ass, and then we'll be friends. As long as ass-kicking is done, we will be friends. If you get soft, then we'll not be friends anymore. You better not have any milk on board. Talk to Liaison Frenic.
Let me explain.
As part of our excavations into this area, we found artifacts from a much older civilization that appeared to share the planet with their gods. In actuality, a species with a much higher technological level than their own. These Daewons were abandoned when their gods left the world, but over time developed their own culture and technology. Then they found the gateway. It's Iconian, but it must have seemed almost magical to the Daewons. Using the geothermal energy, they managed to activate the gateway briefly, but the reaction was too unstable. The geothermal tap caused a chain volcanic reaction that devastated the entire planet. Our scientists say that ash clouded the sky, dropping temperatures and dramatically altering the climate of much of the habitable land. Radiation levels spiked and many of the Daewons died. The survivors retreated to underground shelters, but it was the end of their civilization. Only the flora and fauna that could adapt survive until we arrived. Now that we've found the Iconian Gateway, we feel that it could be a boon to the Romulan Republic. The entire galaxy will be at our fingertips. Smooth little Riemann scientist there. Milk, yes, milk. Milk drinking Starfleet officers. Talk to Commander Tiaru Jarok.
Commander Tiaru Jarok of the RRW Lisette.
She is the captain of the RRF flagship, which is basically a Scimitar class warship. The Republic has advanced enough that we need a flagship on par with the Enterprise. I have the honor of commanding her. My father was a Romulan admiral. He wanted to change the galaxy for me, for all children. He wanted us to be able to live our lives in peace, to be free. He was betrayed for his beliefs and lost everything. I grew up being watched by the Tal Shiar. I heard the whispers that said I was the child of a traitor. When the Tan told me of his plan, I knew this was the world that my father would have wanted. I left the Empress's fleet and never looked back. If you rush through the game, you miss stories like that. And they're nice, you know. If what is Star Trek really without the stories? Maybe that's just my opinion. What is Star Trek without these stories? A bland MMO. That's the answer. Enjoy your dinner, Admiral. I hope you will be back in time for the naming ceremony, which we will be starting after this mission. Let's see, who else can I talk to before we actually progress the mission? We have... It doesn't look like we have the captain of the Enterprise. I forget his name now. Captain Vakel Sean, I think. He's not here, which is unfortunate. Talk to Commander Ninian. Commander Ninian, really? You could have just named him Nyan Nyan Nyan. Nyan Nyan Cat.
Iconian gateways can open up anywhere. You don't have to have another gateway to connect to.
That means the Iconians could show up anywhere. No wonder they control most of the quadrant. Guess that means we need some extra firepower if they show up here. Good thinking. And now the quest. Oh, it's Cooper, is it? Eric Cooper.
Oh, the gateway? Fascinating. Simply fascinating.
The way the teams have... here have used alternative energy sources to supply the immense amount of power needed to reactivate it is. Of course, the Federation Science Council's position on Iconian technology is that it is very dangerous, and if used at all, it should be with extreme caution. Just the opportunity to study Iconian tech is exciting, but to actually see it in use, I never thought I'd have an opportunity like this. I'm keeping my eyes on you, Cooper. Don't make any sudden motions. Talk to researcher D'Arna.
I'm sorry, did you need
D'Adrana. Did you need something? I don't mean to be so distracted, but it's taken a lot of work and a lot of late nights to get here. Finally, we're ready. We've considered everything that could go wrong and planned for any contingency. The D1s weren't as advanced technologically as we are. They hadn't even become a warp culture when they tried to repower the gateway. We have advantages they could only dream of having. There is some risk, of course, but anything worth doing has some risk. We wouldn't be standing on a new homeworld for our people if we hadn't been willing to take a chance and challenge the Tal Shiar. How can I help?
With all due respect to you, Ambassador, I don't think there's anything to worry about.
If you want, I'll review the data my team has collected with you. Admiral Blastrange can review the power variance coefficient numbers for the Alpha, Gamma, and Delta monitors. Oh, yay. Maybe I do need another set of eyes. I've had a lot of trouble sleeping. I'll find those numbers. Okay, let's see. What do we need to do? We need to go over here to this monitor that mirrors Cooper. And I'm still keeping my eyes on him. Don't make any sudden movements, Cooper. You know what? How about you just strap this transphasic bomb to your ass, and if I see you doing anything bad, I will detonate it, okay? Okay, thank you very much for your cooperation. Access power monitors.
Program
you know what?
Select monitoring program.
I wonder if I could make the transphasic bomb into a suppository. And then we can shove it up Cooper's, and then I will be feeling safe, maybe. Program initialized. Select monitoring program. Power output monitors. Power output levels. Blah 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 blah. Alert power from beta feed dropping. Adjust power levels for maximum output.
Program initialized.
Power variance monitors. All PVC within acceptable levels.
Program initialized.
Pylon status. Alpha ready. Beta ready.
Program initialized.
Log off, I guess. Find various coefficients. Speak with researcher D'Arna. Okay.
Were you able to find the coefficient numbers for me?
Segmenting power variance coefficient. All PVC within. Alpha is 14. We have it in the
Alpha
NPC
is
chat
14.
Buffer.
That looks correct.
Gamma is 47.
Yes, that's correct. Gamma is 47.
Delta is 38. As you can see, Ambassador, we have all the numbers perfectly in order. Does that satisfy you?
Your numbers may be correct, but have you ever witnessed the power of one of these gateways outside of a holodeck? Well, I have. I was invited here to share my knowledge with those willing to listen.
Mm-hmm.
Even the best plans seldom survive contact with the enemy.
I think the actual expression is the best laid plans never survive contact with the enemy. Never. I did use that expression in my bachelor's degree thesis. but that was about 2 years ago, so I may be misremembering. Perhaps we should speak with the engineering teams.
Yes, they've been asking for the final power variance numbers.
I'm sure Commander Mayek would appreciate the newest set of data. We will speak to him next. Talk to Commander Mayek.
I appreciate you speaking up about your concerns.
If our projections are off at all, we could end up freezing to death in caves just like the Dewans. This gateway is an extremely valuable resource, but is it worth losing everything we've built here? I have numbers for you.
Finally!
Oh, delicious numbers. You want a full-time job here? I could use some reliable help. Well, now that you ask, being that I'm an engineering specialist, I would love to be part of this program. As long as Starfleet doesn't take away my command of the USS Crotius for it. We'll talk. We will definitely talk. these aren't too bad. Better than what we had before. Maybe this will work after all. That's good.
I agree that the simulations look promising, but I still have some concerns.
So do I, but we're on a deadline.
My team has the geothermal tap operational, and with the proper numbers, we can finally align the power flow to the gateway and activate it again. I'd be happy to discuss your concerns with you, Ambassador, but I'll need someone to help with the final commands to raise the pylons while I monitor the power levels. Admiral, could you help? All of my team are busy with the tap, and it will give the Ambassador and I some time to talk. I'd ask Adrana to do it, but she's got her hands full as it is. Datan invited you here, Ambassador. He had a good reason, and he's a good man. I trust him. If he thinks you have something important to say, we need to listen.
Perhaps we can find a solution that will ensure the safety of all of us. Show me your projections.
I'll activate the consoles and monitor the power readings. It's funny that they only recorded the first part of the line for these guys, almost as if they were too cheap to record full lines. I don't know how much voice acting costs, but I don't think the costs are that prohibitive. still, it's nice that they didn't record the standard lines like they usually do. If you've been watching my playthrough for a while, you will know some funny shit came up during the Riemann side quests, when they were talking about stuff that was completely unrelated to what they were actually talking about in the text. Activate main power. The actual voice parts, I mean, we're talking about something different to the text. Or just repeating over and over and over again. Open pylon doors. Nice, let's see what's down there. The pylons. Ooh, nice, sexy, I love it. Activate gateway pylon risers. Sweet. This reminds me a little bit of Stargate, which I do love. Talk to Commander Mayek.
The numbers are good, but something seems off.
This gateway may not be exactly like the others we've encountered. Off?
Agreed. Sensor readings from the gateways I've encountered were significantly different than this.
Hmm.
Could it be because of the power source you're using?
Continue.
Readings like this make me wonder.
You open a door, and that means there's got to be something on the other side. Maybe this isn't a one-way trip. Do you think there's something on the other side trying to get in?
The numbers aren't saying that exactly, but it's a real possibility.
I understand what the gateway means to my people, but I'm concerned about what it could happen if we open it without taking more precautions. There's an extra it in there. Can we add more security?
Captains Sean and Corin have been consulting with Kerarex security forces. I will ask Corin to deploy some of her finest warriors.
Of course.
I do not know Captain Sean, but he commands an Enterprise. He must be a formidable man. He also has less enthusiasm for activating the gateway than others here. I am certain he has considered all the options.
Finally, we get to speak to Sean. I'll speak with Sean and see what our options are. Let's see, where is the good old captain? Oh, over there. I didn't even notice him. Anyone else I could talk to? Doesn't look like... Cooper is over there being a bitch. Yep. Hello, Captain Sean.
How may I assist you?
Grimo Gikaras Blastrench of the Grotius, I believe. How can I assist you? Good to see you again, Admiral Blastrench. How can I assist you? Again? Wait a minute. How many times is he going to ask how can I assist you? Continue. Yeah. Do you have a moment?
The team looks like it's almost done with the final checks. Make it quick.
Actually, Ambassador Worf has some concerns about the gateway. And because he can't come over and chat with a Starfleet officer without raising some eyebrows in his own delegation, he's sending you instead. Interesting. Tell him I share in his concerns about the gateway. What does he think we should do? He wants an option to neutralize the gateway if we need to.
I'll admit I've been dubious about this project from the start.
Some things are too powerful for anyone to have. Still, it's my job to do what Starfleet Command orders, so the Enterprise is here to assist and represent the Federation. But it's also my job to protect my ship and the Federation, so I had my engineers work up some contingency plans. If Corin is bringing in extra group ground troops to deal with any unwelcome visitors, that should help. My chief engineer worked up a few small spatial charges with enough power to take out the gateway. If we attach them to the base of the pylons, we'll be able to stop a disaster before it starts. I don't want to use them unless we have to. We're here at the Romulan's invitation, after all, but it's always good to have a backup plan. I'll take care of it. Time to place explosives. Yeehaw! Excellent. Explosives. Delicious. Look at that explosive. It's green. Just like Grimo. Oh yes. I believe they can mate. Oh my god.
What are you... Ah, good idea.
What are you doing to my pants? Keep going. Oh my god. Return to Kerelek. Talk to Kerelek.
If all the preparations are complete, I see no reason to delay.
Prepare to activate the gateway. Continue. Witness. I apologize for the lack of music.
Initiating final power transfer.
Power output rising. Levels are within expected parameters.
Activating gateway. Got a spike. Attempting to compensate. No good.
Abort! Abort the mission!
Oh no, it's panic!
Shut it down!
Detonating charges!
No effect. Get everyone out of the chamber.
Well, fuck. Now what, I say? And voice acted.
Into the gateway! Now!
It would have been nice to have a dematerialization effect of some sort. Too bad. And New Romulus went boom. Not really, but I mean, for all we know right now. New Romulus probably went boom. For all we know. It didn't, though.
I knew that gateway would be trouble. We can't get a reading on where we are or how far we've traveled. The best we can figure out is that we are not in normal space anymore. And we are trapped.
By the way, Erka, I agree with what you said in chat. Continue.
The scientists have been able to get a few readings from New Romulus, but the gateway was damaged. We cannot use it to return. A few people managed to grab some supplies on their way through the gateway. They might have something useful. Check the crates. Assist with the wounded. Once we have seen to the immediate problems, then we can worry about getting out of here.
Understood. This mission was a lot more rewarding when you did it during the time it was first released, because you would actually be able to get an obelisk carrier from it, free of charge. Nowadays you have to pay for it if you want an obelisk carrier. Check a crate for useful supplies. Emergency medical kits. Assist the wounded. Data collection technology and portable sensor units, including a few tricorders. I'm also curious how these people managed to carry these boxes with them through the gateway, because the boxes are pretty big, I'm gonna be honest. You find basic field rations and some extreme weather portable shelters. Very nice. I don't know who grabbed those, but you are great at survival. Is this some sort of Iconian facility? Yes, it is. Administer medical assistance. It's my ankle. I can't put any weight on it. I hope we don't have to move quickly. I don't think I can walk, much less run. I know who's going to die first. Scan injury. Level 2 sprain detected. Okay, again, why do you make the engineer administer medical attention? I mean, like, fucking hell, there's... that guy's also an engineer. Okay, fine, I mean, I guess we don't have any medics. Patients should report to sickbay for regeneration. If regeneration is not available, field treatment is as follows. Rest, ice, compression, and elevation. Apply emergency cold pack. Apply compress. And then we do some elevation. Elevation. Treatment of sprain completed. Patient should rest until they can report to sickbay. Does anyone like you too? Continue. I like elevation and I also like vertigo. I also like one. And what was that one that they sang for the Batman movie? Touch me, kiss me, kill me, and something. I'm forgetting the rhyme. Anyway, I like that one too. Administer the medical assistance. Here, have the free medical assistance. I am actually a specialist in engineering, though. So, if you wake up with any surprise implants, ladies, it's not my fault. I'll be okay, Admiral. It's just a scrape. Apply a bandage. Administer medical assistance. It's my left arm. It hurts to move it. Apply bandage. Apply sling. Use thermal regenerator. So, we're going to apply the sling. It feels a lot better. I think I'll be okay now. You're welcome. And administer medical assistance. A rock hit me on the way through the gate. I guess it could have been worse. I could have still been there when the top of the cavern came down. Use auto suture.
I believe I have found a way to open this door, but it will take two of us to override the controls.
Alrighty. Let's do this. I said let's do this.
I think I can open this door, but I will need your assistance. Once I override the security protocols, you will need to rewire the primary motivator to release the locking clamps. Are you ready?
Yes, sir. Continue. Rewire the primary motivator
now
to release the
locking clamps.
Beyond. Yes. All the things. Scan the exits. Ah, okay. Sure. Scan for what is behind the exit.
I am picking up something beyond this door.
No shit.
My tricorder shows this to be a complex of some kind. There is another large room further down this hallway. Interesting. Are you detecting high trace levels of tetrion radiation?
Talk to Worf.
As much as I hate to say this, we will cover more ground if we split up.
Blah. Great idea, Worf.
We should keep in contact as we search.
Commander Ninyon will accompany me.
If there is a way home, we will find it.
I will accompany you.
I'll organize a security detail to remain here. Spoilers, they all get... Spoilers were censored at the last moment. Order Federation Security Officer to organize security. Security? You know... In Star Trek Online, that color is usually reserved for engineering. But, okay, sure. I'll take care of things here. Good luck and watch your back. We don't know who else could be in this place or what they want.
Come. We will find the way out.
Spoilers, they want... La-di-da. Just taking a stroll with Worf. I'm sure there are no Borg here. Spoilers! Some of these spoilers may be intentionally misleading. Interesting. What the fuck is this shit? Let's see. Ooh, I can investigate over here for some reason instead of the web. Scan the equipment. Ambient traces of tetrion radiation detected. Not ominous at all. Scan the equipment. Environmental and life support controls. Data logs show that the environment was recently adjusted from settings non-compatible with most humanoid life. Ooh, so someone prepared for our arrival. Scan the equipment. The multi-adaptive life support system is technology beyond what is currently used by known alpha and beta quadrant civilizations, but it appears to have the wear. Where did the text go? It appears to have the wear and tear of many decades of use. Alright, let's hail Corin.
I'm picking up some odd tetrion readings. Now we've been able to confirm that we're in subspace, but there's nothing conclusive yet.
I think we're in a medical facility, although it's not like any sickbay I've ever seen before. Interesting, Sean.
This facility is mostly automated. Doesn't mean it's abandoned.
We're keeping watch for automated security. Nothing we can't handle yet, but we've found something interesting in this room. It looks like some sort of targeting array. I'm going to try to find out more about it. Perhaps it's a way out.
Maybe it's a way to open a gateway to a location without a corresponding one on the other end.
I'll check in when we know more. Sean out. Ambassador, I think we should take a closer look at that large console.
Good idea. If there is a targeting system and a medical bay, we may find the equivalent of a shuttle bay as well.
Agreed. So this large console is going to solve all of our problems. Investigate. This is the main control console for the environmental controls in this facility. We already knew this. The environment can be set to accommodate a wide range of humanoid and non-humanoid species. Welcome back, Admiral. Whoever used these controls last set the environment for a breathable oxygen-nitrogen mixture that is standard for most humanoid species. you cannot determine how long it has been since they were last accessed. Also, something I forgot to note during the Deferi quest arc. The whole Preserver story really makes it kind of retcons it to be a bit more believable that there are so many humanoid life forms in the galaxy instead of having people that are wildly different. So that was an interesting part of that story, which I forgot to mention. Okay, you cannot determine how long it has been since they were last accessed. Continue.
We have not heard from the security detail. We need to check in with them.
Hail the security team. Security detail, answer.
Are you sure something here is not blocking our communicators?
Pretty sure.
This is suspicious. We should check in with Corin and Sean's teams.
Captain Corin, come in.
Corin here.
We haven't found anything this direction yet. I'll return to our starting location and find out what's happened. Good luck, Sean.
I've found what appears to be some sort of targeting system.
Huh, that's strange. Captain Sean, what is it?
Did you hear that? We should...
Ensign, look out!
Oh, noes! The mission is going well so far.
Captain Sean's team is in trouble. Hurry!
The mission is going well so far, I say to someone in chat, while everyone is getting abducted in the game. Oh, noes. Let's see if we can find these people before they get eaten. Spoilers, they get... Ooh, what's this? Examine tricorder. Sean's tricorder, it's still recording, but there's a 4-minute gap in the file. Examine weapon. Standard issue hand phaser. A Starfleet issue phaser, but this one has had several adjustments made to it to maximize its power. The work is impressive. I wonder whose that is. If it's Sean's, it's a little bit far away from, you know. Let's see. Examine toolbox. It's a standard issue toolkit. You know the ensign with Sean was carrying one like it. Examine smashed comm badge. That doesn't really look like a smashed comm badge. That looks like someone peed over it. Anyway.
No sign of Sean's team. We are not alone here.
Oh, Hayden. Investigate strange technology. This appears to be a targeting system of some sort, with settings for 6 coordinates. It shares some characteristics with a transporter, but the technology is so far beyond that what you've seen before that you're not sure you would be able to operate it. I am an engineer. I should be able to do this, at least more than I can administer standard first aid to people, okay?
This does not bode well. We should rendezvous with Corin and the others.
Return to the rest of your refugees. Hayden is trying to submit his application for being a mod by saying lewd things and or potty humor. Mostly potty humor. I'm sorry, but talking about poopies is not going to get you modded today. Maybe later. I don't know why I said poopies instead of shit, but I'm trying to be cute about it.
Without their supplies or weapons. Can you hail them?
Hail anyone! Anyone?
We must find Corin and the others.
Really? They actually left a line that wasn't voice acted. We may find the answer we seek there. We need to hurry. We're all in danger here. This is me hurrying. Good water. Let me get some more water. Finally, we can. No. Okay, now we can go. So, you are saying we need to hurry, right? Okay, let's hurry. Recover the others. Follow Corin's path.
Wait. I know this place. I have been here before.
This does not look ominous at all, I'm sure. Also, you know what? The model here, this model, like, really bad texture. Like, what the fuck, man? A 5-year-old could have textured this. Anyway. Investigate strange table.
This table? I saw one just like it when I served on the Enterprise.
Investigate evidence of fight.
Blood. Klingon and Ferocin. Corin put up a fight.
Investigate data core.
There are data entries here that correspond to our missing people. They will be taken for examination soon.
Dun, dun, dun. Discuss.
It was a Solanogen-based race, and I have seen this before. When I served on the Enterprise, we attracted attention of aliens who existed solely in subspace. They abducted us, experimented on us. We did not know why. But their actions went far beyond mere curiosity.
Continue.
We were able to stop them before they established a pocket of subspace on board the ship, but not before they sent a burst of energy through. If these aliens served the Iconians, that energy could have been a message. Corin was not taken without a fight. Of that I am sure. And this table has not been used yet. These aliens must be holding the others. It is only a matter of time before they will be examined as well, and the experiments can be deadly. Everyone here is in danger. We must find and free them.
We'll find the others. Also, Hayden, I think Amazon just messed up the transporter coordinates for your delivery. Spoilers, Amazon has transporter technology. I may be lying. Maybe.
There is a holding area down this hall. We should... Automated defenses! Defend yourself!
Pew, 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 pew.
That guardian
pew,
was
pew.
Damaged by a disruptor. Corin's work.
Are you sure it wasn't your disruptor? Because you just shot it with a disruptor. Just saying. Attempt to open the door.
We can overload the power cell from that guardian. It should blast through the door.
Or we could use my transphasic bomb, but the mission is not scripted for that. Perimeter sweep complete. No unauthorized gateway access detected. Dispatching sentries. Unauthorized beings found. Taking appropriate measures. Unauthorized beings apprehended. Taken to holding cells to await examination.
Be ready. There may be more guardians beyond this door.
Probably are. And... Aw, I didn't get to clear the explosion. Boom! Nice. The anti-proton beams at the end of this mission are worth 600k apiece, says Hayden. Well now, That's cool. I thought they were blind on pickup, though. In progress. Sphere of influence. They are pretty nice beams. Bind on pickup. Hayden. You can't fool me. I know this game. Each of these is bind on pickup. Anyway. It is a nice array, and I'll probably pick that one. Scan titanium ore. Yay, titanium. So we have some dead drones, and we have some people. Not the omnidirectional beam. Which one, then? Disable holding pen. Captive removed from custody. Okay, let's see who's still here. Some more of our dudes. They probably did change it, I guess. Disable holding pen. Okay. There is a pen with just some investigation stuff in it, I know. Three captives. Okay, nobody here, I guess. The cell is empty except for scratch marks around the door. Someone tried desperately to escape. And an identified assault drone. Pew, 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 pew. Nice. And a dead person. I wonder what that person is supposed to be. You find a desiccated corpse. It's not from a species that you recognize. Let's see. Don't think I know that one. If anyone recognizes what species this guy or gal should be from, let me know. Purple, kind of weird jewelry, ridges. Looks a little bit like a Deferi, but purple. Anyway, last cell.
I don't see Captain Sean or Mayak here.
Where are they?
There's no more time.
We need to stop wondering about this place and get back to New Romulus. Staying here is only going to get more of us killed.
No. There is still someone missing who could be saved. We are not leaving without them.
He's right. We keep looking. DDDEEKKK says, if you upgrade that Omni Beam, you can slot the upgraded one as well as that one. That is true. Borg. Okay, no Borg here. You can, because basically the upgrade system is a little bit weird. If you slot something into the upgrade system, it immediately turns that item into another kind of item of the same stats. So you really need to keep this in mind. If, for example, you have a set of something. If you have a set of something, you probably won't get the set bonus anymore if you try to upgrade anything and not upgrade the other parts. So if you put any item from a set into the upgrade system, into this slot right here, be sure to put all the other items from that same set into the upgrade system as well, so that the set can be recognized again. If not, you will lose the set bonuses. That happened to me with the Dyson ground armor stuff. I tried to upgrade my Dyson armor, and I lost access to the 3-set bonus because it counted the Dyson armor as a different type of item, and it didn't count for the 3-set bonus, even though I had all the items equipped. So I had to take the shield and the gun and put it in the item upgrade system. And then it counted everything as normal again. You don't actually have to upgrade anything. It just changes the type of item, the background type of item that it is, if you put it in here, directly when you put it in here. So he was saying that you can have two Omnis at the same time if you put one in the upgrade system and have the other one normal, because they probably don't get counted as the same type of unique. So you can do that if you want. Probably good for shuttles, I would imagine. Maybe I'll try that sometime later. Recover the missing. Find Sean and Mayek. Okay. Mm-hmm. Oh, no. What is this? Ew, they're getting experimented on. Okay, let's summon my drones. And then we'll kick ass. Phaser turret. Here, have some drones. Drone fight. Nice. Release Sean. Sean is pale and unresponsive. His breathing is shallow and his pulse rate is dropping. He requires immediate medical attention. Diagnostic scan. Why am I doing this? A tricolor scan shows that Sean's left arm and both antennae have been surgically amputated and then reattached. An unknown foreign substance has been introduced into his lymph nodes, and his superior vena cava has collapsed. Sean's cardiovascular and lymphatic systems have been seriously damaged by the experiments. He requires immediate medical attention. Suggested procedure. Regenerate veins. Restore circulatory function. Purge lymph nodes.
What happened? How... Can you help Mayek?
Continue. He's probably dead. Examine Commander Mayek. A quick tricolor scan reveals that Mayek's blood has been completely replaced with a synthetic liquid polymer. Even immediate medical attention would not be able to help. His family and friends will want to know what happened. He has been pumped full of... This reminds me of an episode in Arrow, when there was this guy who killed the women, and then he used some sort of special substance to preserve them as dolls. So basically something like that happened to Mayek. He pumped that into their... Yeah. Yeah, we'll want to know what happened. Maybe we should bring back the Mayek doll. That should keep them company. I mean, it might keep his wife company. Oh,
that's distasteful. I shouldn't have said that.
It may not provide comfort, but it could provide closure. You carefully remove his communicator and identification so they can be returned to his loved ones. Captain
Sean? There's nothing more we can do here.
If you want any hope of finding other survivors or stopping what's happening on New Romulus, we need to keep moving.
Agreed. The best way to honor Mayek's memory is to save his new home.
Alrighty. Follow the energy signature. Exit through the doorway. Anything to say for yourselves? Doesn't seem like, so let's go through. Dun dun dun.
The gateway energy signature is emanating from somewhere across this expanse. We need to find a way across.
Continue.
My scans indicate there's some sort of control system at work.
Perhaps you can use that to activate a connection to the next platform.
I'm picking up more of those automated defenses.
They are at my tricorder's maximum range, but they will be upon us quickly. The wounded are too weak to put up a fight. We should cross quickly and make our stand from a position of strength.
You should scout ahead.
Of course I should.
And Sean will remain with the injured and defend them if the Guardian drones arrive.
All right. So these are all the people we have saved so far. Let's use the console. It's pretty dark here. I don't remember it being this dark.
We will escort the others when the way is clear.
It's really fucking dark. Now, you don't really need to explore all this area. There is a right way to go. However, you do find some interesting tidbits of information if you go through the entire thing. So system Sol. You can see it in the background here. Earth. Dominant species, human. Servitor presence, level 4 surveillance in effect. Ideal site for harvesting. Servitor races have used disease epidemics and internal conflict in ancient past to gather specimens for study. Population is numerous but mostly peaceful. Poor candidates for servitor status. High creativity levels and self-preservation instinct make them inclined to fight rather than submit when faced by overwhelming foe. See Borg for more information. Can be aggressive when threatened. Recommend that all activities in system be covert until invasion is launched. Target for extermination. If Sol system is eliminated, models show that political entity known as Federation may collapse.
The Sol system. Earth.
Indeed. Let's extend this bridge, which is the wrong way to go. We need to make our way over here. So dark. Let's see what this console has to say about things. Use the console. Storage facility Z98. There is no planet or anything. Purpose: supply and transport servitor troops during expansion and pacification actions. Capacity: 4.7 million units. Docking stations: 220. Current status: error. Alert: storage facility Z98 has been in stasis mode for error cycles. Connection to gateway network unstable. Lucky for us. If I use that again, does anything happen? No. Same dealio. Okay. This is all basically Iconian stuff. So you get an idea as to how fucked up we would get if they actually decided to invade. However, I was talking to my fleet mates a few days ago, and they were expressing... they were saying basically that they don't know why the Iconians don't just attack. And my theory for it is basically that there are probably too few Iconians. They're a very commanding species. They're very into their own power. So there are probably not that many of them left, because they would probably kill each other if they thought they were a threat to their power bases and so on. And there are probably just a few of them left. So if they actually engage in direct warfare instead of through servitor racers, even if they have the technology to kill millions, someone could get lucky and kill one of them. And if there's only something like maybe 2 dozen Iconians left, that could only take 2 dozen lucky shots, and then they're all dead. So they probably wouldn't want that to happen, and of course they probably have too high a self-preservation instinct to want to expose themselves to actual combat. Use the console. System Konos. Where is it? Over there. Green. Nice. I like it. Dominant species. Klingon. Servitor presence. Level 4 surveillance in effect. Aggressive, warlike species that dominate this area of space. Strong tendencies to fight rather than submit. Harvesting programs in past have been problematic. Only successful when used in concert with internal conflict. Possible candidate for servitor race. If key members of government and entities known as Great Houses could be used to direct the rest of population. Military structure is most organization. Military structure in most organization makes population already accustomed to taking orders from superiors. Recommend study of honor in society for use as a tool of control. If population can be absorbed into servitor species, it would be a great addition to our fighting strength. If they cannot, extermination must be swift. We cannot give the Klingons a chance to organize against us.
Kronos. This is not a holodeck. It is a live image of my world.
Indeedy do. Extend bridge. Apparently you can't go through there. Though I would have liked to try. Oh well. Let's go this way then. Discover information, 2 of 6. Alrighty. Use the console. What is this? System Vandross 4, species Dominion. Servitor presence level 9 surveillance in effect. Dominion scientists discovered an intact gateway 37 cycles ago, but it was destroyed by opposition forces before they could activate it. There are other gateways in the region that remain inactive. Agents are in place to stop the Dominion from discovering the location of these gateways before we are prepared. As to the Dominion themselves, we recommend observation but no engagement. The Dominion are organized and used to subjugating large numbers of species spread across a large area of space. When the Alpha and Beta Quadrant are firmly under our control, then we will have the resources needed to conquer the Dominion as well.
Vandross 4. I remember this world. We found an Iconian gateway there during the Dominion War.
Alright, let's search this way for extra information. Very dark. Let's see, use the console. Alert! Connection to gateway network unstable. Immediate attention required. Gateways 7,255. Gateways inactive 5,967. Gateways damaged or inoperative 880. Alert! Gateways in Andromeda active. Alert! Unauthorized connection to network. Detected in Hobus system. I think we've already been to Hobus, so that's not really news. Okay. Anything else? Alrighty. Now, during the event with the Obelisk carrier, you could actually get, I think, either rare or very rare Swarmer pets, combat carrier pets, out of one of these consoles, which should be coming up soon. I don't know if it's still the case, but we're about to find out. Probably not, though. Probably not. Let's see. Ooh, what's this world? Use console. System, New Romulus. Dominant species, Romulan. Servitor presence, level 8 surveillance in effect. Survivors of Romulan extermination have gathered on site a former D1 homeworld. They have uncovered sites belonging to servitor races and are attempting to reactivate Gateway. If Gateway is successfully activated, they may threaten entire network. Attempts to use Elachi to eliminate threat unsuccessful. Alliance with Tal Shiar problematic. Romulans as a species show more self-determination and willpower than in previous observations. Leader known as Sela must be controlled or eliminated. And they have Sela. They abducted Sela. So, we're gonna have to see what happens with that. Continue. Several key members of Romulan Republic Gateway Research Team have been taken for additional study without their knowledge. Brain scans of researcher Adrana have yielded vital information about project, which is probably why she hasn't been able to sleep well, because someone has been scanning her brain. Agents have used that information to destabilize Gateway. If activated, seismic instability will affect entire planet. Expected outcome is 70% reduction in population. That's an interesting way to put it. Expected outcome is 70% reduction in population. 70% of all Romulans now settled on New Romulus will die. Because old Romulus was not enough. They have to... Oh my god. Remaining survivors must not be allowed to form organized groups. Recommend subsuming them into Elachi as soon as possible.
New Romulus. The tectonic activity is getting worse. We must find a way to stop it.
Indeed. Extend the bridge. And then I fall off and die. The end. So now we need to go through here, but we'll go through the green one as well to see what's over there. Use the console. System, Iconia. Dominant species, none. Servitor presence, level 1 surveillance in effect. The homeworld is still unsuitable for inhabitation, although servitor races have begun subspace modifications in preparation for invasion. When the quadrant is pacified, we will use forced labor to terraform world for our return. All must be as it was.
I know this planet.
Indeed. Let's see. There's also some weird things on the map that those must be some sort of swarmers somewhere placed. Weird. Can't see them though. Okay. Random scannable thingy. Let's use the console though. Alert. Safety measure Theta 6 in effect due to gateway instability. All space gateways for large ship movements have been withdrawn to subspace until network instability is addressed or proper activation codes are transmitted. I think you should have been able to get these swarmers from this console. No, maybe this one. Yeah, probably that one. Alright. We'll see. We'll see when we get there. I'm purposely not going to read the next information console so it doesn't progress the quest or something, just in case it's connected to that somehow. Let's see. So we have the console here. We need to find out. Nope, closed off. Apparently you can't have access to this yet. Let's see what the console says. System, Quara. Species, Quarren. Servitor presence, level 6 surveillance in effect. Industrious and technologically advanced planet. Extremely low level of automation means population must constantly refresh workforce. Use of radioactive mines to infect ship crews and bring them to Quara is interesting, but ultimately inefficient. We would require greater amount of loyal servitors to pacify Delta Quadrant than this method would provide. Recommend cooperation and eventual inclusion as a servitor race. In exchange for their loyalty and detailed information on their indoctrination techniques, we will alleviate their manpower problems. Interesting. Interesting.
The Delta Quadrant? Does the Iconian influence reach so far?
Yep. Let's go through here and see if we get some free swarmers out of it. Use the console. Current status. Ship Obelisk 1. Servitor Solanae. Status ready to deploy. Activation codes authorized. Waiting for navigational input. Accurate complete reconnaissance, but it doesn't look like we have any swarmers here. Yeah, I guess we don't get any free swarmers. Oh well. Either that, or I'm supposed to go back somewhere where it wasn't, where I wouldn't have had access before, and then I don't know. I'll look into it maybe, and I'll tell you some other time what the status of the swarmers is. Extend the bridge. Probably limited time though. Limited time during the event that happened with the obelisk as well.
This appears to be some sort of master control panel. I believe we can use it to open the gateway.
Alrighty. Attempt to reroute power.
Can we access the database? We must know what the Iconian plans are.
Pew 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 pew. Do you speak pew pew? It seems like you do, pew pew. Let us negotiate in the language of pew pew.
Download the data and move everyone here before more guardians arrive.
Indeed. Summon everyone to platform. Alrighty. Reroute the power.
I will remodulate the power system while you reroute the flow.
That's a star chart. Are all those markers Iconian gateways?
Look! That's the new Romulus gateway!
Which one? I don't actually see it. Reconfigure controls. Shit. I didn't see what color flashed. Incorrect. Watch. Yellow, yellow. Okay. That happened too fast after the last one. Fuck you. it blended into the last one, so I have no idea where it began. So fuck you. Let's just do yellow, 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 and reset the thing. And now, fuck me. Okay, show me again. Green, green, yellow, yellow. Okay, thank you.
The gateway on New Romulus was reset.
It wasn't the only one. Ambassador, we'll cover you as you download the data.
Establish the data link.
The paths are retracting.
They know we're here, and I don't think they're happy.
You hear that? That doesn't sound good.
Yep, swarmers all around the background.
We should use this gateway.
Warp! We're out of time!
Millions of them. Swarming all over. We are so fucked if we don't get out of here right now.
I have downloaded what I can. It is time to leave. We have cut the network's connection to the New Romulus gate, which should stabilize the situation there. There will be some damage on New Romulus, but it could have been far worse.
Continue. Let's get ready to run! Huh? Oh, just have to go through that no activation. Okay, where are we?
This is a bridge. We have walking wounded, but some of us can still serve. Where do you want us?
All over the place. Console. Appears to be a tactical console. Captain Sean, very good. Would you like a side-to-side transport? Investigate console. Captain Corin, bridge control for engineering functions. Sensor and deflector dish controls. Adrana. And now we fall through and die. Investigate console. Primary weapon controls for Ambassador Worf.
We have saved the Romulans' home world, but The gateways are open now. All of them.
Dun dun dun.
We do not know who will use them. It may be the Alachi, or it may be something far worse. We must warn everyone of what is coming.
Activate the gateway and take us out.
Receiving tactical telemetry. I'm detecting another gateway in the Juret system. It's big. Ship-sized.
The gateway is transmitting a high-band subspace signal. Sensors are picking up Elachi ships on an intercept course.
I suggest we go there and contact New Romulus for reinforcements.
Agreed. Can we use that gateway?
Not from here. I can make a gateway for us and set a destination close by, though.
Do it. Make it so.
Taking us out.
Nice. But you can plainly see how they did that trick. With a box they put the ship in. Basically. The edge, one edge being farther. It's nice, though. It was fairly obvious.
Sensors show that we are in the Juret system. Systems are all reading normal, but object sighted near the ship. It is an Iconian gateway.
Hail the Romulan Republic.
I'm very glad to see you all safely returned. When the quakes began, we lost all communications with the gateway chamber and feared the worst. But where did you go? Through the gateway? And what is that ship? I've never seen anything like it.
I'll provide a full report as soon as I can. Suffices to say that we had to open the entire Iconian gateway network to save New Romulus.
You reset... elements preserve us.
There we go. Auto firing. Elements preserve us. There could be hundreds of gates. Thousands. Approximately 7,000. Are they all active now? Minus the 880 which were damaged. Yep. There was a ship-sized gateway hidden in subspace in this system.
Enough talk. The gateway is transmitting a signal. I am picking up a corresponding one from an entire fleet of Alachi ships on an intercept course. Send every available ship. We must fight if we are to survive.
Continue.
Sending reinforcements now. Good luck, and may the elements protect us all.
We will hold the Alachi here until reinforcements arrive.
We will hold off the Alachi until allied forces arrive.
What's this?
Press the launch button to create a wing of fighters to aid you in combat.
Yep. Thanks. I know that. Reactive anti-proton cascade. Taunts the target and up to four other...
To send your fighters after the selected enemy.
Thank you. Taunts the target and up to four other targets within
activate
5 kilometers. My god. And
activate intercept mode, and your fighters will prioritize
yes.
Small targets such as torpedoes.
And
activate recall mode to call your fighters to return.
Begin repairing, yes, I know. So, anti-proton cascade taunts four targets. Two self passive all energy damage resistance rating for 20 seconds. Nice. Activate anti-proton cascade. Okay, we can get another set of fighters, though. I wish I had beam fire at will with this. The thing about playing with these loner ships is you always have this completely messed up stuff on the hotbar that you have no idea what the fuck is going on. And you also sometimes have special abilities like evasive maneuver Sean 6. What the fuck does that mean? I would have to spend the next 10 minutes just figuring out the abilities on this thing, which I'm not going to do. Oh, I missed with the overload beam. The fighters, these swarmers are doing work. What level are they? Ah, they're just rare swarmers. Pretty good stuff, though. Pretty good stuff.
We need to hold the Alachi until reinforcements arrive.
Understood.
Wrong one, I guess. And...
more Alachi inbound. Hold them off.
Oh my god. Mombosh battleships. Yeah, that would do it. But honestly, I should really do forward facing with the weapons I have. Attack pattern, thingamajigger, rough target, whatever. All the things! Improve all weapons, yes! Shoot! Okay, so that somehow was being fired at well. Okay, great.
This is Commander Tiaru Jirak of the Republic flagship Lisette. Where did that gateway come from?
Subspace. It is one of many activated to prevent the destruction of the new homeworld.
Over Sean 6.
Enterprise Death Shot.
Luckily, the fighters I launched are doing all the work. Because I have no idea what's going on.
Glad you can make it, Enterprise.
Oh, Sheshar Dreadnought. Well, fuck.
The Alachi can send their entire fleet. We will not fall.
Okay, let's do a quick one. Jump here. Okay. Destroy the dreadnought! Yes! Yes! Kill it! Nice. Good stuff. Good stuff. Defeat Alachi fleet.
There is still the matter of what to do about the gateway. That discussion cannot be delayed.
Agreed. Fuck.
The Alachi forces have been destroyed. No further hostiles inbound. Captain Sean, the Enterprise should scan the gateway. We need to know more.
Agreed. But we should destroy that gateway now, while we still have the chance.
No! That gateway is in Romulan space. It belongs to the people of the Romulan Republic.
Yep.
Another invading force could arrive at any moment.
Afraid of a fight? Captain!
Corrin, prudence is not cowardice. The gateways are powerful. They may be too much for any of us to control.
We should disable it before it becomes another threat to the Romulans, and to us all.
How is this different from the wormhole near Bajor? This is a strategic and scientific asset, and it belongs to my people. Captain Sean, if you destroy the gateway, I can assure you that Titan will reconsider our friendly relations with the Federation.
The Klingon Empire will fully support our Romulan allies in this matter.
Enterprise to Captain Sean. Sir, we've been scanning the gateway.
What did you find?
The terminus is at a fixed point now. We can determine that. But then, I don't know what we picked up, but the monitors on the bridge are all showing an Omega.
Whoopsies.
We're locked out of the computer, and engines are offline. We need you back on the Enterprise, sir.
I see. That changes things significantly.
Indeed it does. I should return to the Bordescue. Worf will be waiting for you. Corrin to the Bordescue. One to transport.
I should return to New Romulus immediately.
Ambassador, it was a pleasure to work with you. I wish we could have had that talk.
Agreed. Another time. Send my regards to your chief engineer, Captain.
I'll let Chief O'Brien know.
Ooh.
Sean to Enterprise. Transport me directly to my ready room.
I didn't know O'Brien was still serving on the Enterprise.
Today was a glorious battle.
Well, serving again.
You have won much honor for yourself and your allies. It seems there are larger conflicts.
He's talking over
all
me.
Of our people will need to face. If we are to survive, we may need to face them together. It was an honor to fight beside you.
Ooh, I thought I had accidentally gotten out of this area and I wasn't going to be able to grab my loots. Give me my loots. Probably not going to be anything good, but pick the items. Mmm, delicious. Okay, anything else? Nope. But I don't need to take a screenshot. Like, Admiral suggested that I take a screenshot of the setup of this ship. I can just mouse over it, because we are recording. Just in case anyone is interested at any point, or wants to have advanced knowledge of what they will have to deal with when they're in this mission. Probably won't be repeating it, then again I might. These are stats, of course, modified by my captain's abilities. Oh, what's this? Interesting. Reactive anti-proton cascade emitter. I think I have one of those. I'm not sure. On another captain, though. Obelisk swarmers. And special abilities, we just have hazard emitters. Everyone knows that. Feedback pulse. Factor beam repulsors. Gravity well. Engineering team, I think I don't know this one. Reverse shield priority, I never used this one. Emergency power to shields. Directed energy modulation, I should have used that during the fight. Beam overload 1, and we have finally some unique stuff. Evasive maneuvers, Shawn 6. It's basically like evasive maneuvers, except you can use it when evasive maneuvers is on cooldown. Coincidentally, I don't even have evasive maneuvers on the hotbar because everything is overloaded. So shit. Good thing we had Shawn 6 then. It is a good day to die. Buff damage, debuff target resistance. Oh, nice one. Nice one. Very nice one. And Warrior's Way. Pretty much beam fire at will. But also, yeah, and torpedo spread 3, so it's all in one, apparently. Very nice. Okay, I think that does it for this mission. We only have shield capacitor. Ops. Yep, take us out. I like the way that the fighters arrayed themselves next to the ship. It's kind of sad that you can't just dock fighters and take them with the experience they have gained to other maps. But hey, it would be probably overpowered. So, sphere of influence. We're going to complete this. While it is regrettable that so many gateways were unlocked, I know that together we will face the future. Our governments will be in contact in regards to this Omega situation. When we are prepared to act, I know you will be involved. Thank you, Admiral, and good luck in the future. So let's see. The warp core is pretty nice. I would have to, you know what, let's take the beam first. It's pretty good. Maybe I might even equip it. I don't know. It has good stats. If not, I'm going to put it on a shuttle at some point. And next we have Sphere of Influence, which will begin the actual Dyson reputation chain. But we will get to that later. Okay, that does it for the mission.